Oh, that was a good catch. Today, we'll be going over Spice Bomb Extreme, and you have to give her credit. This is one of the best packaging brandings of all time, called Spice Bomb, looks like a bomb. They even have the stopper. Oh my God, man, the packaging on this one. Listen, I used to make music, if you check out my old videos, right? I remember this one quote from 50 Cent. He said, "I know a song is good when I wish I made it." And when I look at the packaging on this one, I'm like, oh my God, I wish I would have created this packaging, calling it Spice Bomb, making it look like a bomb, then having the stopper. Oh my God, it reminds me of the guy from the Fantastic Four. I think his name is Johnny, like spray on and boom, boom, boom. I get like, it's such a playful kind of vibe. Like I get encouraged to spray this fragrance. I literally just wasted sprays because I just enjoy going like this. Like, I don't know, man. You gotta give credit where credit is due. Packaging on this one, one of the greatest ever in fragrances, period. Anyway, let's get into this fragrance right here. Today we're talking about Viktor & Rolf Spice Bomb Extreme. One of the most coveted fragrances in the game. A lot of people love this fragrance. A lot of people rave about this fragrance, but does it truly live up to the hype? Here's my opinion on this fragrance right here. One, it's like a designer slash mainstream version of Tom Ford's Tobacco Vanille. Tobacco Vanille by Tom Ford, I love that fragrance personally, but it's a little bit polarizing. That tobacco is a little bit harsh, it's a little bit dirty. As soon as you smell it, you're kind of like, oh, do I love it, do I hate it? I'm not sure what to think, but when it gets to the dry down on that fragrance, it is so sexy. This fragrance right here, on the other hand, it just makes it more mainstream. It makes it more likable, makes it more mass appealing. So imagine, Tom Ford Tobacco Vanille made more mass appealing, you have Spice Bomb Extreme. Second thing you should know about this fragrance right here, it's one of the best winter fragrances ever. The spice combination right here with the vanilla just is so captivating. When I go to like Bryant Park in New York City around Christmas and they have all these different like food carts and they're selling like hot chocolate and they're selling all these Christmas related items, the first fragrance I think about is Spice Bomb Extreme. This literally captures New York City holidays for me instantly. As soon as I smell it, I think of New Year's, Christmas, and holiday seasons. Third thing you should know about this fragrance right here is it lasts a long time, but the projection is not too loud, okay? This is a very close, intimate kind of fragrance. If you're looking for projection and loud, you're not gonna get that out of this fragrance. But when I smell it, literally 12 hours later, I'm still able to pick it up on my skin. So longevity on this one is insane when it comes to how long it lasts, but the projection on this one is not that strong. Fourth thing you should know about this fragrance right here, it's not signature scent worthy. To me, I feel like this is a fragrance I'd only wear around the holiday season. So like fall, winter, cool spring night where it's kind of like breezy and I'm going out for the evening. But I don't see this being a signature scent due to the lack of versatility. This is not a fragrance I would personally wear in the summer. I feel like it'll choke people out. I would definitely not wear this one in the gym. In the office, you can wear this one, but I just wouldn't wear it personally around like spring and summer days in the office, especially if like the AC breaks one day and you're like projecting and people are smelling Spice Bomb all over the place. Like, I just feel like as a signature scent, this is not the best, but when it comes to the winter and fall time, this is hailed as one of the greatest in my personal opinion. Now with that in mind, it's also, who is this? Oh, come, I'm literally filming. Yo guys, look at this, perfect time, listen. Yo, you can't lie though, like, it's called Spice Bomb.
Okay.
And it looks like a bomb. And it got the little
hand grenade.
Oh my God, right? You can't lie though, like the packaging on this one.
It's nice, I like this, this is cool.
Now, what do you think of the fragrance smell? Mm. Oh, really? Take it.
It's okay, it's all right.
Smell the
spice though, the spices.
It's spicy, right? Yeah. It's spicy. Out of 10, what would you give it?
It's okay.
That's how it comes.
Just like this?
Yeah, and you just pull it.
Some foolishness.
What do you mean? I love it.
Can I give it like a 5?
5? What?
Like, I'm not gonna be like, oh my God, what are you wearing? You know what I mean? Like, or if you pass me, I'm not gonna be like, oh, you smell good. You pass me, you just don't stink.
I feel that. I feel so. To you, out of like all the other fragrances that I showed you, like this is not one of your favorites.
Yeah, no. It's not something I'm gonna constantly reach for.
Do you feel like, in your opinion, this is my opinion, mm-hmm. I feel like this reminds me of like fall, Christmas, I'm going to Bryant Park, I'm going to the market, I'm gonna get myself a hot chocolate.
I'm gonna get a pumpkin spice latte.
That's the vibe I get off the fragrance right here.
But it does, it's just regular degular, but it does give me fall and winter vibes. It's not a spring or a summer scent. It's not something you wanna wear during those kind of seasons. It's too musky for that.
Yo, try it out. Like the little. Can't lie.
Yo, you're gonna lose this. You're gonna be tight.
Nah. You know what? It reminds me of like the guy from the Fantastic Four, like, boom, flame on. Like, you know?
Flame on. You're so annoying. Flame on. Oh. But I mean, it's nice. It's all right. It's cool.
I mean, listen, guys, I literally got you a raw ladies' reaction on this one. So you have to respect the honesty, because honesty is the most important thing. And if that's something you learn from my fragrance channel, then that's good, right? You see, I'm teaching people other things outside of fragrances.
I know, right?
I'm doing the community a service.
Yeah.
Anyway, you can leave now.
Okay.
Yo, imagine
let me take me.
Just get out alone out of here. Nah,
get out of here.
How was work today? So you saw my friend's reaction and it was so crazy because like literally it was so on plan, but I'm like perfect because like I knew what I was gonna say when it comes to the compliments factor, because I've had so many other girls tell me what they think of this fragrance and it's always the same exact answer. It's okay. Like they're not mind blown. Like when I showed them Creed Aventus cologne, they're always like, wow, what is that? It smells so masculine, so sexy. This one I'm always getting like okay reactions when it comes to the ladies. So when it comes to the compliments factor, it's okay. Now, in my personal opinion, should you buy Spice Bomb Extreme? Now, before you blow up the comment section, you see what I did there? My answer might disappoint some, but to some, they might agree with me. I would say no. It lacks in versatility. Ladies' reactions is okay. Projection is okay. In my opinion, this is a fragrance I will get when I already have some sort of fragrance collection going on. This would not be the first fragrance I go for. This would not be my signature scent. So the only way I could justify somebody buying Spice Bomb Extreme is if you already have some sort of small collection. You never want to drop the bomb, guys, because things might blow up. But yes, guys, I would not personally buy this as my first fragrance. This again will be just a winter and fall fragrance and it lacks in versatility. But again, if you have some sort of small collection going on, I think this will be a great option to add from there. But anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed my review of Spice Bomb Extreme. If you did, give it a like, leave a comment below, and make sure to subscribe.